So our next question is from a helpline caller, and they're wondering, if your PSA is rising and they know it's a recurrence, is there a certain place in time where we need to go for treatment and this is indicated just by the PSA rising, or do they need to see a biochemical recurrence? Does there need to be metastatic activity? What does that look like?
Well, if I understand the question correctly, how urgent is it to get after the cancer if it's relapsing? And the answer comes down to whether or not someone is hoping to cure it. As I mentioned, there is a possibility of salvage cure for men that are relapsing. And of course, in those situations, the earlier the better. But there are men that have maybe been through this rigmarole a couple times. Maybe they tried a salvage cure and it didn't work and went on hormone therapy. Now the PSA is rising. Intermittent therapy studies given with hormone treatment suggest that allowing the PSA to float up to 5 or 10 is not dangerous, that men can take a holiday from treatment, allow the PSA to rise up, and then resume hormone treatment. So if the goal is cure, earlier the better. If the goal is quality of life, say in an elderly man who's on intermittent therapy, it's not as critical.
Another question we got from Helpline, is there a number, like a cutoff of the number of spots for metastatic spots, like lesions on the body, where spot radiation won't work anymore?
Well, arbitrarily, the experts have suggested that maybe 5 spots is the maximum to treat. The problem is the more the spots, two things occur. One is that if you see 5, there's probably greater numbers that you don't see. And then the other problem is that when you radiate spots in the bone, you sacrifice a small amount of the immune system because the bone marrow is where the immune system forms. So selective treatment of small areas is perfectly safe, but you start treating more and more areas, then you have the potential for weakening the immune system. So they say a maximum of 5 spots, but certainly it's much more ideal if it's 1, 2, or 3 rather than 5.
Now, going back to the radiation topic, if a person has had radiation and they suspect it's possible, like a radiation bump in the PSA, how often and when should they be checking this PSA?
Yeah, before we had these PSMA PET scans and the Axiom PET scans, we had to just tough it out because we didn't have any way to cross-check whether some cancer was showing up somewhere. And the policy was to check the PSA every month and then look for a pattern of smooth, steady, unremitting rise, which is characteristic of a cancer recurrence, versus a zigzag inflammatory pattern, which is characteristic of a PSA balance. And by having more data points, you're able to make a distinction between these two possibilities earlier. And then, of course, if it is a cancer recurrence, get started on treatment. But we can really clear the fog by just doing one of these scans and finding, is there any cancer that has come back? The only exception to that is that the men that undergo radiation to their prostate glands, it's been shown that it takes about 2 years for the cancer to completely disappear from the prostate. And this has been demonstrated in men that have had biopsies, random biopsies stuck into the prostate 1 or 2 years afterwards, and they can see residual cancer. But if you wait 3 years and re-biopsy, the cancer is gone. So it takes a while for the cancer to die. And if a person undergoes a PSMA PET scan in the first year or two after treatment, it's possible it'll show some viable cancer in the prostate, even though that cancer is destined to die because of the radiation that was given previously.
Do most doctors know that? So would some doctor come in and go, well, there's still cancer there, we need to do it again, we need to re-radiate? I mean, what situation would that cause?
Well, there's possibilities for all kinds of confusion, partly why we do these videos. I've seen doctors treat men who had rising PSAs from inflammatory bumps, and the doctors assume, unfortunately, that it's cancer and put them on hormone treatment when no cancer was present. So there's a real need to be educated about this evolving world of technology that we have.
So the next question I have is there a general prognosis for men with relapse confined to the pelvic lymph nodes?
Well, those are the ones that were more hopeful for cure. I have had men that have had isolated bone metastasis, which we generally consider to be a worse prognosis, maintain durable remissions and get cured. So it's not impossible, but it's the people that have relapses in the lymph nodes, which is the most common site of relapse, that have the highest hopes of getting salvage radiation, salvage hormone treatment, maybe even a short course of chemotherapy, and successfully eradicating all the disease. The chances for being cured, much better if it's just one spot, perhaps as high as 50-50 for a second chance at a cure, and then dropping down maybe into the 15 to 20% range if there's multiple lymph nodes in the pelvic area.
How often should the PSA be checked after treatment when it comes to surgery and radiation?
So the usual policy is once treatment is completed to check the PSA every 3 months for 2 years, and then for the subsequent 3 years out to 5 years, three, four, and five, to check the PSA every 6 months, and then after that annually. That is a it's sort of a general schema. People have to remember that the checking the PSA when the testosterone is still low is different than after testosterone has recovered. And when men have had hormone therapy, they should have their testosterone checked every 3 months so that the date of when testosterone recovers is recorded, and then you know at that point, the clock really starts ticking as to the possibility for cancer coming back.
Thank you so much for watching. If you would like more information, you can visit our website, pcri.org. Also, subscribe to our YouTube channel. We come out with new prostate cancer videos every week.